Look at this. You can recognize this. It's a cup of coffee. Not many people like to have it for their breakfast. Some people like to drink it during the day. Some other people like it sweet, some others not so sweet, and some others they don't like sugar at all. However, there are people that coffee for them is dangerous. But before I start with this, I need to tell you some information for the coffee. Caffeine is found in varying amounts of grains, leaves, and fruits of some plants. Where it acts in natural pesticide that paralyzes and kills some insects fed on plants. It is most commonly confused by humans in infusions varied from the coffee beans and leaves, as well as from the various fruits and beverages containing products derived from pistachio cola. Other sources include yerba mate, guarana berries, and Ilex vomitoria. In humans, caffeine reacts as a central nervous system stimulant, resulting in temporary progression of drowsiness and the restoration of alertness. Caffeinated beverages such as coffee, tea, some soft drinks and energy drinks are very popular. Caffeine is the most widely used psychoactive substance in the world, but unlike many other psychoactive substances, it's very legal and advocated in most of all countries. In North America, 90% of adults consume caffeine daily. The organization, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration, lists caffeine as a multi-purpose product generally recognized as a safe food substance. Caffeine has diuretic properties, at least when given in adequate doses, and those who do not tolerate it. Regular users, however, develop a strong tolerance for this phenomenon, and studies have generally failed to support the common perception that regular consumption of caffeinated beverages contributes significantly to dehydration. However, it's also used for a combination with other substances to treat headache and migraine. However, what happens when it reacts to an oversensitive person which is necessarily more sensitive than other people? People who are OCD or something, people who have sensitivity to coffee. Well, today is that story. Our story takes place in Greece. This is Panagiotis. He is a man who never tasted coffee before. and he was curious one day to try it. So one day he went to a shop and went to buy it.
Drugs, call it caffeine, call it lust, call it sexy. I look sad, but I'm happy, and you have got me high all the other times. But I've been falling down, down so hard. I need your love.
The first cup of tea for him was nice. He enjoyed it. So he wanted to try it once again. So the next day he went there and did it again. As the days was passing, he was drinking more and more and more and more coffee. But he never drank 2 cups. After many months of drinking coffee, Panagiotis started to suffer. He started to be over-energetic and nervous. He was doing many things to get his nervousness out, but he couldn't handle it. At nights, he was suffering. He couldn't sleep at all, and he was a man who couldn't sleep, and he was getting nervousness around his people around. His friends were getting worried, and all around him now seemed ugly and scared. He was scared. He was feeling like he was going to die in his sleep. The only way for him to relax for a while was to drink some pills that help him to relax his nerves. Panagiotis had to relax from this. So he decided that it's not right to drink coffee every day. So he decided to have a rehab from the coffee. So he stopped drinking it. For a while, it took some time. His body was not able to handle it. So it was hard because he was feeling a little weird, little stressed. He was feeling like he wasn't needing it. However, he was trying to handle it to do not have more problems in the future. One night, when he went to sleep during his rehab, he kept spinning at his bed. So he was so worried, so the only thing he wanted to do at that time was to stand up and dance. He knew it will help him. He was feeling like it. So he just stood up and starting dancing. A small problem, because as long as he was dancing, he wanted to dance more and more and more and more. So he started to dance faster and faster. And then all he wanted was to get his energy out. So he kept dancing and just dance. The next day, after a month of rehab, Panagiotis was feeling better, but he was ready to buy a coffee. But then his wife stopped him, as she was telling him that it won't be right for his body to react to this again, because if he drink coffee again, he will get the same problems. So Panagiotis decided that he will drink coffee only rarely, because his body is too sensitive for that and cannot stand it. No matter if you enjoy something that you drink so much, you should not drink it in big doses. Because if you keep drinking it and drinking it and drinking it and drinking it, you will start having problems in future. Do not say that you won't have problems because you don't have them now. You will have them in the future. So please be careful, because I don't want you to be in trouble.